ArchiCAD allows you to connect curtain walls to walls in an intelligent way. This is advantageous because the connected walls will follow all the changes of the curtain wall during the entire life cycle of the design, and all quantities will remain accurate. For instance, if the curtain wall slant angle is modified, the wall connection will be immediately updated. We are going to connect the walls and the curtain walls in the 3D window. Open the 3D window and modify the view as shown on the screen. Select the two walls and one curtain wall. Display the context menu by right-clicking an empty area in 3D. Select the Connect or Join Walls to Curtain Wall command from the context menu. Click on Join in the upcoming dialog box. Move the cursor towards the outer part of the building and click to remove the unnecessary part of the wall with the eye cursor. Repeat this with the other curtain wall. Select the two walls and the curtain wall. Connect the walls to the curtain wall using the corresponding command from the context menu. The mullions of the curtain walls are not at the correct heights. The upper point of the top mullions of the distinct panels should be 150 mm above the story levels in order to cover the slab edges as well as the false ceiling space. We have to adjust the scheme of the curtain wall accordingly. To do this, we are going to measure the required distances in the section view. Double-click on the S1 building section in the project map of the navigator. Click the measure icon in the toolbar. Zoom in to the section view. Measure the distance between the top of the mullion and the story level line. You can use guidelines parallel to the frame if necessary to create an intersection with the story levels. Please note that the distance is 865 mm. We need to lower the panels by 715 mm so that they extend past the story levels. We are assuming a floor cover thickness of 150 mm above the story level. Select the curtain wall in the section view and choose Edit in 3D. The view will change to 3D automatically. Now, we enter curtain wall editing mode. All other elements are grayed out, but their geometry is still available as snap points. In the Settings dialog box, we can set the visibility of the members of the curtain wall. Set to show the scheme only. Hide the frame, panel, junction, and accessory. Select the upper part of the curtain wall. Click on a transom and choose the Move Grid option from the PET palette. Move the cursor downwards and type D. Enter 715 in the tracker. The scheme will change immediately. Click OK when finished. Please select the bottom part of the curtain wall and repeat this edit. Please select OK when finished editing. You may carry out similar modifications on the curtain wall on the other side of the building if necessary. Measure the required distances in the section window and then carry out the modifications in the 3D window so that the upper point of the top of the mullions are 150 mm above the story levels. Open the S1 section and check the result of the modifications. Let's get back to the floor plan by double-clicking on the first story in the Navigator project map. Check out the other stories as well, and note how the cut line of the curtain walls changes across the stories according to the curtain wall inclination. On the first story, select the bottom four columns. Modify their top link to one story. Due to the curtain wall inclination, these would stick out of the building envelope. Click on Continue in the upcoming dialog box. Since the two towers will be centrally symmetrical, Repeat the same with the upper four columns on the opposite side. Now, 3 times 10 columns remain in the center. This will be the column arrangement of a typical story. Let's look at our tower on different floors. Notice how the cut lines of the curtain walls vary according to the level of the different stories' cutting planes. To better visualize the concept, let's select both curtain walls and open the Curtain Wall Settings dialog. Display the floor plan and section page and open the Floor Plan Display section. Instead of symbolic with overhead, let's select the projected with overhead option for the floor plan display. Select entire element for show projection instead of 2 floor plan range. Click OK to close the dialog. Now let's browse through all the floors. The elements are represented differently on different stories depending on the height of the current cut plane. For our purposes, let's use the original floor plan display settings. Select the curtain walls again and open the settings dialog. Modify the floor plan display of the curtain wall to projected and the show projection to 2 floor plan range. Click OK to proceed.